immunity specialist. Like any other viral infection, COVID also can present to you as a fever, which we all know, fever or throat pain or regular cough. But in most cases, we of course know that there is breathlessness. There is also a fever which keeps on recurring. The body ache is more. See, these days, of course, we treat every case of fever as COVID until unless proved otherwise. So the first thing that we do is, of course, isolate yourself, which you have already been told. Secondly, you can start taking light steam. Steam is also important because it helps to kind of humidify your sinuses, to circulate them. So in that case, when there's circulation of air, any sinus disease is prevented. Any recurrent throat infection is prevented, because once you are humidifying the sinuses, the mucus becomes healthy. And in that case, what happens, there is this post-nasal drip of mucus does not irritate your throat. Another thing that I feel that one should go for is a lot of oral hygiene, you know. We generally, as laymen, what we do is that we start gargling. The first thing that we do is gargle. See, now when there's a tonsillar infection, gargles are good. But when there is an infection a bit deep down, or say in just the back of your throat, sometimes gargle does not reach there. So in that case also, steam is very important. Oral hygiene, what I spoke of, you need to regularly brush at night. Most people do not practice that. In COVID times, at least, we should always maintain oral hygiene so that, you know, no other viral infection can disturb our metabolism. Another thing that we also have to keep in mind is that these symptoms that nowadays are quite common because of the pollution and the change in the environment, of course. What happens is that, you know, this post mucus drip, the post nasal drip, it increases. As soon as this post nasal drip increases, throat problems increase. So the first thing is that go to an ENT specialist, go and rule out a problem in the nose. Since the nose is the first filter, we need to rule out that there is some anatomical problem in the nose, a common thing like a deviated nasal septum, or it could be any hypertrophic turbinates, or it could be slight sinus disease which is, you know, gradually going to increase. Of course, when their situation is quite prolonging, it is recurring every year, in such cases what happens, we need to rule out nasal polyps as well. Sinus disease, whenever it arises, there are two ways of treating it. The first is a conservative management, only through medicines. See, most cases of sinus disease can be treated with medicines and exercises. However, when there is an anatomical problem, no medicine, no exercise can actually help you until and unless that anatomical problem is kind of reduced by us. It has to be treated and it has to be cured. Otherwise, your sinus symptoms will keep on increasing year after year. We can just give you momentary relief with medicines. Another thing is allergy. Allergy is, you know, recurrent sneezing, which does not exactly lead to sinus disease. However, if the nose is blocked and you're not breathing through the nose, then in such cases, mouth breathing increases, circulation does not happen in your sinuses, then gradually this disease in your sinuses will increase. So if it's just allergy, let your ENT specialist decide. If it's just allergy, just conservative management and exercises will treat you. At least we will control your allergic symptoms. We will tell you how to deal with it. But if there is an anatomical problem already existing, that needs to be cured. Maximum people come to us and tell us, you know, we are sitting and examining the nose and they are telling us, no, this is happening because of allergy. Allergy is completely different from your bony deformity. The bony deformity will of course cause symptoms similar to allergy, but the whole course is different. You know, there are people who come and tell us that, ma'am, if there is a bony deformity that you're telling us about, will our sneeze reduce? See, we can reduce your sneeze by removing this bony deformity, by making you breathe well. However, if you are allergic to a certain smell or certain pollens, let's say, or a change in weather, dust, we cannot exactly remove that. We can reduce it, but we cannot remove it, because that runs in your blood. Your blood cells react to these allergens. Allergens are external stimuli. So what happens, the nose reacts, and if there's any anatomical problem, these symptoms are increased, are exaggerated, and that's when the problem starts. That's when the sinus disease starts. So always go to an ENT specialist to rule out any other problem besides allergy. Other than that, also allergy also needs a thorough consultation, because in such cases we are there to help you and at least guide you.